This video demonstration will guide you through the process of creating, editing, and running an ant build file. Using oXygen XML Editor will benefit from features like validation, content completion assistant, search and refactoring actions, and master file support. Our project contains a small company's human resource information. All personnel data is stored in several XML files. Our goal is to use this information to create a small personnel presentation page. We previously created the XSLT stylesheets needed to generate the HTML output. Also, the project contains additional resources like CSS files, images, and some static HTML files. We'll use an ant build file instead of a plain XSL transformation because our web project needs to have a certain directory structure. It depends on some additional resources that need to be copied in the deliverable directory, and the personnel-related content needs to be dynamically generated depending on the available information supplied by the human resources department. Editing the build file will use the content completion assistant and validation features. We'll create a new ant build file. And save it as buildhtml.xml. We'll name our project Personnel Webpage. Now we'll have to create an entry point in our build file, which is the target executed by default when no other target name is supplied to the launcher. This is done by specifying a value for the default attribute. The automatic validation kicks in, letting us know that the build file is invalid because the specified target does not exist. We declare an extension point with this name. And now the file is valid and the error is gone. To make the project more flexible, we'll declare some properties to refer the resources we'll use in our build file from now on. First, we'll set the output directory property. Note that when the content completion assistant is active, a short description is presented for the currently selected item in the list. Similarly, we'll declare other properties. The first ant target in our build ensures a clean output directory. It will delete the content generated by previous runs of the build. We'll name our target clean. We'll delete and recreate the output directory to prepare the environment for the rest of the tasks the build will perform. Inside the target element, the content completion assistant proposes the list of all available ant tasks and types. This includes the built-in tasks and types, as well as the custom ones. Since we want to delete the output directory, we choose the delete task. The content completion assistant also provides the list of available property names. This includes the properties defined earlier, as well as the system properties currently set in the Java virtual machine. Let's recreate the output directory structure. The next step is to copy the additional resources in the output directory. This target depends on the previously created one. Now let's copy the CSS files, then the images, followed by the additional HTML files. Similarly, we write targets that generate the table of contents and the HTML pages for each person in the company. Now we completed the individual steps of the build process. All we need now is to tie them together. Returning to the entry point in our build file, namely the generateHTML extension point, will add the previously defined targets to its depends list. Once again, the content completion assistant helps us to add the target names to this list. Once we completed writing the ant script, we review it. Since we are not happy with the names of some of the components, we decide to modify them. Let's take, for instance, the out.dir property. To ensure the build script consistency, we need to modify all occurrences of this property. To quickly find out where this property is used, we just click the property name and oXygen highlights all its occurrences in the current file. Next, we'll invoke the rename component action available in the Quick Assist menu. Note that all occurrences are decorated with a thin border, indicating that the in-place editing mode has been activated. This means that all the changes you make to the component at caret position are updated in real time to all components' occurrences. Now we edit the property name and then press Enter to commit the changes. Now we are happy with the current form of the build file and we are ready to test it. oXygen comes with a predefined transformation scenario that allows us to run and builds. We'll use the default settings to execute our build file. In the results area, oXygen displays the execution log. The build was successful, so we'll check the output. Back to the project view and refresh the output directory. Now we open the index.html file in a web browser. The outline view displays the list of all the components, properties, targets, and references defined in the current and build file or in the imported or included files. The components can be grouped by their location, which is the end build file they were collected from, and by their type. The components displayed in the outline view benefit from the entire set of search and refactoring actions. Moreover, we can switch to the classic node-structured outline view using the Show XML Structure action available in the Settings menu. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.